In today's class, we will learn about problems on Fourier transform. The problem is find the Fourier transform of the function f of x equal to e raised to minus times mod of x. Solution of this problem we'll see now. The problem is find the Fourier transform of f of x is equal to e raised to minus mod of x. So solution. So the given function is e raised to minus times mod x. So e raised to minus, because here they have not given any interval for this, so we need to find it. So just I will explain here how to take the limit. So we have minus infinity, 0, and we have plus infinity. Always remember, so mod of x means here we have it is minus x, and this part is what here, plus x. For minus infinity to 0, this will be minus x. From 0 to infinity, it will become plus x. But we have what here, minus mod of x. So just see how to write it here, the function. So f of x is equal to, so for this mod x, so this mod x we can write the interval. So this mod x, for minus x it is lying between minus infinity to 0, and for plus x it is lying between what here, 0 to infinity. So therefore the function f of x can be written as, so function f of x, which is nothing but e raised to minus mod x, can be written as what here. So mod x for the interval x greater than minus infinity less than 0, in this interval it is minus x, but because of this minus sign, this minus will become e raised to what here, plus x. And for 0 to x, what here, greater than 0 but less than infinity, it is plus x, but because of this minus into plus, it will become e raised to minus x. So this is very important here. So because of this minus sign, so this part will become plus, and this part will become minus. So this is the two functions we got for the f of x. So f of x is lying between what here, minus infinity to plus infinity, but for minus infinity to 0 it will become e raised to x, and for 0 to infinity it will become e raised to minus x. So therefore, by the definition of Fourier transform, what we have, so capital F of u is equal to integration minus infinity to plus infinity f of x into e raised to I u x into dx. But just you observe here, so but minus infinity to plus infinity is in addition of two integrals. That is, first integral is what here, minus infinity to 0 f of x into e raised to I u x into dx, plus another integral is what here, 0 to infinity f of x into e raised to I u x into dx. So which is nothing but, so for minus infinity to 0 the function f of x is what here. So for minus infinity to 0 the function f of x, it is nothing but what here, e raised to x. At minus infinity to 0 is e raised to x. It is e raised to x into e raised to I u x into dx. For 0 to infinity, it is what here, e raised to minus x into e raised to I u x dx. So first simplify, then we'll go for the integration. What is simplification? Because bases are same, we can add the powers. So therefore it is nothing but f of u is equal to integration minus infinity plus infinity, bases are same, add the powers. So e raised to, while adding the powers I will take x as a common, so it will become 1 plus I u into x, because I added the powers x plus I u x. So x, if you take common, it will become e raised to 1 plus I u into x into dx. Plus again for the second interval also, the bases are same, add the powers, so it will become e raised to, so while adding the power it will become minus times x plus I u x, I will take minus common, it will become 1 minus I u and x common into dx. So now it will be easy for integration. So you apply the integration. Integration of e raised to x is what here? E raised to x only. So, but in coefficient of x we need to differentiate, it will become in denominator, so which is nothing but on integrating it will become e raised to 1 plus I u x divided by 1 plus I u limit from minus, this is 0 here, minus infinity to 0, plus second integral e raised to minus 1 minus I u into x divided by, so integration of minus I minus times 1 minus I u into x is nothing but minus 1 minus I u, so limit from 0 to infinity. So this integration is very important, and this problem also. So then we'll see on applying upper and lower limit what happens here. So which is nothing but f of u is equal to, so here for the first term 1 upon 1 plus I u I will take common, means I will take outside. If you apply upper limit x has 0, e raised to 1 plus I u into 0 is become e raised to 0 first term, minus second term if you apply it will become e raised to minus infinity, because x will be replaced by what here, infinity, means infinity, anything else again infinity, we'll check here. Then second plus into minus is minus, 1 upon 1 minus I u will keep as it is, and if you apply upper limit it will become e raised to minus infinity minus e raised to 0, because x will be replaced, but e raised to minus infinity or plus infinity always it will be 0, and e raised to 0 is 1. So but e raised to minus infinity is 0 and e raised to 0 is 1, so therefore the function f of u will become 1 upon 1 plus I u into 1 minus 0 plus second term will be 0 minus 1, 1 upon 1 minus I u we have here, 0 upon 0 minus 1, so therefore which is nothing but 1 upon 1 plus I u, so plus into minus is minus, 1 upon 1 minus I u, so this we got as f of u. But on taking LCM, LCM is what here, 1 plus I u into 1 minus I u cross multiply 1 minus I u minus times put a bracket 1 plus I u, which is nothing but, so this is A plus B, A minus B, it will become 1 square minus I u whole square, so 1 minus I u open the bracket minus 1 minus I u, so plus 1 minus 1. Here is the correction, so this is actually minus sign as from the previous step, so this is also minus minus, it will become plus sign, so plus sign, so if you take a plus, so this will become plus plus, so minus I u and plus I u cancels, we will get 2 upon 1 minus, so I square into u square, I square is nothing but minus, minus into this minus will become plus into u square, so therefore we got finally, so the function f of u will become 2 upon 1 plus u square, which is a required Fourier transform. So in this way you need to simplify the problems.